It is now 7:06. You have exactly 8 hours and 54 minutes to ponder the error of your ways. Any questions?
Yeah. Does Barry Manilow know that you raid his wardrobe?
A brain, a beauty, a jock, a rebel, and a recluse.
I can't believe this is really happening to me.
Before this day is over, they'll break the rules.
Chicks cannot hold a smoke. That's what it is.
Bare their souls.
Are your parents aware of this?
Take some chances.
Being bad feels pretty good, huh?
And touch each other in a way they never dreamed possible.
Why'd you do that?
Because I knew you wouldn't. Oh.
The Breakfast Club. They only met once.
I don't want to be alone anymore.
You don't have to be.
But it changed their lives forever.
I mean, I consider you guys my friends. I'm not wrong, am I?
Universal Pictures presents Emilio Estevez, Paul Gleason, Anthony Michael Hall, Judd Nelson, Molly Ringwald, and Ally Sheedy in a John Hughes film.
Why are you being so nice to me? Because you're letting me.
The Breakfast Club.
Oh my goodness.
Wah,
that's
wah.
Crazy.
There you go, it's a literate treat. Oh my god,
I just don't know what to do. I've never dated a girl like her, and I don't have enough money to give her the gifts that she wants.
Our anniversary's coming up. Did you get me anything?
Not yet.
Well, I've got a couple ideas. It'll depend what you're up for, though. Step one, you're gonna study. Step two, you're gonna start taking SATs and other tests for people.
Please help me do my SAT.
Can you like do my SAT?
You're gonna get a ton of money, and you also get to keep your rich girlfriend.
Which one of you is Devin?
That's me.
I need you to do my SAT.
I'm not doing this for you.
You asked for it. There's something going on about this student. I think you need to know about it.
Devin, step into my office, please. I didn't do anything. We have standards at this school. You're suspended.
You're taking the battle of the band seriously this year. You're out. Maybe it's time to give up those dreams. I did, and things are going really great for me.
Tempting.
I'm not a temp, I'm a sub, and soon I'll be a certified teacher.
Is this Mr. Speedley?
I'm the principal here at Horace Green Prep, and we need somebody to start immediately.
So how much are we talking here?
$6.50 a week.
Hello, this is Ned Schnabley.
Everyone, I'd like to introduce Mr. Schnabley.
All right, look, I've got a hangover. Who knows what that means?
Doesn't that mean you're drunk?
No. It means I was drunk yesterday.
I heard you in music class. You guys can really play.
Why didn't you help me? I think it's time we started our new class project. Rock band.
Can we tell our parents?
No! Lead guitar, Zach Attack. On bass, Posh Spice. Keyboards, Mr. Cool. Drums, Spazzy McGee. You three, groupies. So who do you like?
Christina Aguilera.
No.
Puff Daddy.
Wrong.
Liza Minnelli.
Wow! What are they teaching this place?
We have a red alert. Smollett.
To your positions. E equals MC squared. Oh.
If from now on you could just stick to the curriculum.
Is she always like that?
Except for the time she got drunk.
She did a Stevie Nicks impersonation. I love this song.
They're gonna laugh at me.
You've got something everybody wants. You've got talent.
The story of a man who gave a class
inspiration. I pledge allegiance to the band.
The Rock. Jack Black. The School of Rock.
I can sing.
All right, Summer, belt it.
Memory all alone in the moonlight.
Stop. Okay, good. All right.
Rocking around,
Santa.
This guy believes in Santa.
Mom, my friends keep making fun of me because I believe in Santa. Is he real?
Honey, you know Santa's real. Look at all those presents over there.
Mr. Kringle, welcome.
We've been having some problems with some of the students lately.
Naughty little boys won't be a problem for me.
Who threw that? James, do you know why you're here?
I'm investigating the disappearance of Charles Smith. You was the last person he was with.
Attention, please. Everybody in the conference room.
Pretty Lampard.
Am I gay?
Body image.
Damn it!
That was awesome.
That's what she said.
What is the most important thing for a company? The people.
False.
I think that pretty much sums it up.
Thank you.
I am hungry. I have been hungry. I was born hungry. What do I need? I am something. I have been something. I was born something.
Savannah Hearts means, it means the world to me. All the things that I see in the hallways in the school, I see you guys create magic every day.
So I try to give my students ample opportunity to make choices that they feel would best serve them in the context of our classroom, as far as gaining content, applying the content, and using it later on in life.
The environment here really fosters good learning, and I've enjoyed being a part of that. In working and teaching and trying to foster creativity with my students and myself, I like to give projects that I think that they will be excited about. I also work in the classroom with them. There's various times when I'm painting, and so that inspires them as well, and they can see what I'm doing and incorporate some of the things into their work as well.
About individuality in classes is really difficult. I feel like as artists, we try to be individual, but most importantly, as performers, that's the best way to do that. It's part of their life, whether this is something that they do past Savannah Arts. My main goal here is for them to love what they do and be passionate about dance and their life in general.
The uniqueness of Savannah Arts, I would say, compared to all the other schools that I work, is that your respect for each other. I think you guys respect each other to the point that I haven't even seen any one of you get upset with another student. And that's amazing. You know, in my own, when you talk about teenagers, there's something that's always going to bother a teenager. But you guys seem to hold it in and focus on your art and your academics.
I've met people that have lived in Savannah their whole lives and have never been on the water. You know, I think, you know, the journey is part of the destination. I've been fishing as long as I can remember. It's just something I've always had a passion for, always enjoyed it. How long have I been fishing? Most of my life, so 28 years probably. I've been doing professionally for 9 years now. I worked, you know, several different jobs, military, and got out and couldn't really find my happy place. So I quit my job to be a full-time fishing guide and haven't never looked back. It's my passion. It's what I love doing. It's what I, you know, lay awake at night thinking about, you know, what the fish are going to be doing the next day. It's a puzzle, and it's challenging every day, and I like figuring that out.
We're a watchdog for the water resources in a given territory, so we try to advocate for the river, its tributaries, groundwater, and keep it clean for the public. There was a lot of challenges for our region moving forward on the water resource side, as far as surface water pollution and impacts.
I'm big on responsibly harvesting, taking care of the resource, making sure that, you know, we're only taking what we're going to use, what we need, and then what's going to get eaten, and then let the rest go.
The leader and a number one kale hook, which is a modified circle hook. It's not only better for catching the fish, but it's better for releasing, because most of the time it gets in the corner of the mouth. So if you don't want to kill the fish, it's got a much higher survival rate. I want to let it just drift with the current. So I've got enough slack out right now.
There's a fish.
Go. Reel. Rod up high. Go, reel, got a reel. He must be from Alabama. He's missing a tooth. This is like the perfect fried fish. Yum. It's not fishy. It's really delicate white, you know, meat. One of the reasons we have so many regulations now is because we didn't used to have the regulations before. So people would just go out and catch and keep and kill whatever they wanted. And you will see a decline in the population if it's not regulated a little bit. But I think that's probably the number one thing is, you know, going out and enjoying the resource, but protecting it at the same time. And those of us that harvest fish are probably the biggest proponents of conserving that same resource. Because I want my great grandkids to come out and catch redfish that are, you know, great grandchildren of the fish I'm catching now. You know, and if we deplete the resource, then there's nobody to replenish it later on. You know, it's not an infinite resource like we used to think of it as just, oh, the ocean's full of fish and, you know, we can't fish it out. Well, we realize now, like, we impact it.
I don't know, with fishing, like, what is it about fishing that draws so many people to it, right?
Right.
Like, how is it possible that I make a living off of other people's hobbies? Like, it's just fun. And I think one of the cool things about fishing is the process. The fishing is part of the reward. It's not just catching that fish. Some of my best days, you know, have not been the days that we've gone out and caught 100 fish. It's been the days that I've had awesome people on the boat. Maybe the fishing's been tough, but we've worked really hard and, you know, succeeded. Maybe at the end of the day, we caught a big giant redfish after we worked for 6 hours to catch it.
Oh my gosh.
Like, and that happens. There's days where you just don't catch anything for long periods of time. And yet that's part of the reward is the experience of doing it.
All the chemicals that we release in the environment, you know, a lot of them make their way into our bodies, either from drinking water, from breathing, or from the food we eat.
I don't think Savannah would be here if it wasn't for the water. You know, we don't have a lot of farming on the coast because the soil's not fertile, right? So without the water, without the ecosystem and all the marine life, like, we probably wouldn't have a city here.
Hi, my name is Mia Stewart, and these are my threads of inspiration.
Tasties! Look at those shoes. Let's get a close-up.
She would always outfit her hats, gloves, purses, fancy dresses. That's, I think, that started the cogs turning.
Free bear hugs! Tasties! Say it again.
Mia is studious. She is very, she's a born leader, and she works very hard on her designs.
Mia is very headstrong, very resilient, very creative. She has a really great fashion and style eye.
Just a great all-around student.
Fashion has brought joy and new meaning to my life by giving me something for not just myself, but others to enjoy. For people to be able to see things I can bring to life, it brings me a lot of joy. The thing is that fashion is the most interactive art that there is. And seeing a runway, you can go and feel it, people can wear it, its movement and its design.
Fashion is art. You know, what we wear every day is art.
I have always done traditional art, but then fashion has just always been implemented in that. There is no different connection between them. They are completely intertwined. So this year's fashion show experience has really shaped my passion for fashion. I saw my fabric and I knew that it was on theme, like with metaphysical aquatica under the water stuff. So I found that it was much easier to work with this year, and it helped me enjoy like the process of making and like creating my my dresses. So the process of creating a garment collection starts with an idea. Me personally, I like starting with Pinterest boards, and I put different fish textures that I liked. I put different seaweeds, I put different colors.
Then we draw and design our garments. Then we go into pattern making after we take the measurements of our models. We do muslins, which are our first initial garment to test it out. That's where the challenge becomes. You have to kind of use your knowledge of basic sewing construction.
And from there, you would drape the prototype, and then you would cut the garment and the fashion fabric, the finished product.
This is so embarrassing, actually, but I would get pieces of toilet paper and start like sewing like string through them because I wanted to practice my sewing skills. I don't know. I draw the most inspiration from my mom.
Hey, mommy, here's a birthday girl.
She is a jewelry designer, so from a very young age, I've always looked up to her.
As Mia grew up, she always loved creating. She grew up in a household, because I'm an artist, she had lots of hands-on between crayons, watercolor.
When I was little, I would always go into like Michael's and I would find these fashion books that had like the stickers of outfits that you could put on them, and I just always loved playing with them. So I think that was kind of a sign to me that I really enjoyed doing that.
What I really think sparked Mia's interest in fashion, one of my good friends was a photographer for Junk Defunct, and when Mia was 7, she took Mia and her daughter to see the show, and after the show, Mia just came home big-eyed, like something inside her clicked, like she wanted more of that.
I probably could not imagine my life if that joy of fashion was taken away from me. It's just part of me, which I've been very, very lucky to be able to know from such a young age that I've been wanting to go into a fashion career, so that now whenever I apply to colleges or whatever I do, I can say that I have things under my belt. Like, I know how to sew, I know how to do other things that some people who may decide to start now in their fashion career don't have. The message that I hope to tell the world through my fashion creations is for people to just feel good when they wear my collections. I want them to feel like they are wearing art, and it's not just something that you throw on every day, but it's more sculptural and more something that can only be worn on the runway. In 10 years, I hope to see myself with a family, but also obviously having a fashion career, so balancing those two at the same time. In life, you want to pursue something that brings you joy, and this specifically really does bring me joy.
In 10 years, I see Mia probably wearing a pencil skirt, stilettos, and some sort of Chanel type jacket, working in some fashion house.
The creative director at some type of formal or evening wear company.
She will be, you know, a designer, or she will be a pattern maker, or in marketing. Mia is a great student. she's gonna go far, you know. She's a born leader, and she's wonderful.
I couldn't be more proud of her.
Ready? Here we go. I'm ready. I don't know. Honestly, I don't really know how to answer this question, so.
It's awesome to be back.
I know. I've been waiting for this all summer.
Back to the rules. Honestly, sometimes I wish there were more.
How was your summer?
That was good.
Yeah, mom was whatever. We usually go on vacation, but we didn't this year because my grandma died.
Oh. Yes. That sucks.
That's cool.
Yeah. Well, if you're gonna get the right side of the story,
it's a good thing he came to me.
It was the first day of school when the announcement said,
"Good morning, students. Welcome back to Northside High. This year will be a little different from last year. After countless complaints, we have finally perfected our new rule book. Failure to comply with these new rules will result in disciplinary action. Have an awesome day, Tigers."
Everything was fine. I was just trying to enforce the rules. Your hair's untidy. It was in violation of rule number 23.
That's ridiculous, man. Come on. No hair ties, no buns, no nothing. What is this, Footloose?
You will be expelled.
Loosen up a little.
This is war, so I gathered a trusted group of rule followers.
I texted a few friends.
We are the students triumphing discipline.
What? I don't get what's so funny.
Our name is the Rebels, obviously. But when I heard what those nerds came up with, I almost fell on the floor laughing. I mean, come on, STD.
Your hair is untidy. That's against the rules.
Then give me a hair tie.
I can't. Hair ties are against the rules.
And why is that again?
Because they're a choking hazard. You know all of this.
I know. I just wanted to know if you hear how crazy you sound. How could someone choke on a hair tie?
Well, babies choke on hair ties all the time. Chewing gum is against the rules.
Says who?
So, we saw that incident between you and Janet. Can you talk more on that?
I can't believe she would do something like that. I mean, the audacity. She needs to stay in her own lane. She needs to mind her own business. My hair is... it's literally none of her concern. I mean...
the disrespect. I mean, really, who puts gum in someone's hair? The hair! Like, that was low. That was really low.
This recent development has been most infuriating. It's one thing to steal Max, but to steal from Mother Earth? The Rebels have crossed the line. Okay, troop, today's the day. We show those Rebels who's boss.
Okay, today's the day. We'll show those STDs who's boss.
Good afternoon, Tigers. It has come to our attention that we may have overstepped with our new rulebook. We will be adjusting it accordingly, and when we return from winter break, all will be right again.
Man, this whole situation is something out of West Side Story. Well, except no one fell in love.
If I have to teach you how to be a reporter.
Over time, there's nobody working.
Good morning, Jim. We are alive.
To recap, coming to bases is no easy feat. Everyone is admitted on their scholastic performance and entrance exam test scores. Your dorms, classes, curriculum, and assignments are all dependent on it. That being said, all of you have been ranked according to your scores, which are prone to change throughout the course of the year. These changes will be made remotely via fax machine. At graduation, the top 10 students are eligible for a full scholarship to the school of their choosing. All of you are very smart individuals, so you must stay competitive. At the end of this video, your administrator will assign you your new student ID and your first project of the semester. Try not to overwhelm yourself, and remember, someone is always watching. I'm Principal Dean, and I'll see you next time.
I'm Noah. Hi, I'm Noah, future valedictorian of Lincoln High, top ballet soloist in Tennessee, and president of the chess club. I know I am not a 97!
Well, if there's nobody I know you how to be a reporter, I'll let you do that later.
I want to do that later, Jim, but I think we'll be...
Hey, do you have a partner for the project already?
No.
I'm Noah. I guess we're supposed to use our numbers. To be honest, I don't really like mine.
So okay, I'm River. I don't like my number either.
I'm glad somebody gets it. I just don't understand how I rank so low. I think I just went up.
I promoted to 24. Can you read it again?
I've already read it a million times. Working in pairs, you must develop a project based on the topic of competition. We have 9 weeks to work on it, and we can't share anything with any other group. It couldn't be more vague.
Maybe it's like a stepping stone for a bigger project. After all, we are like cogs in a big machine, right?
Or maybe it's a way to raise our ranking.
Are you still caught up on that?
I'm telling you, there's gotta be something wrong with this school.
Whatever.
Yes?
Are there any computers we can use for a project?
No.
What do you mean?
If you can excel with analog devices, you can excel anywhere.
Well, our topic needs specifics.
If you need research materials, feel free to use the library.
Great.
But you're only cleared sections 22A through 23C.
Who came up with that?
Principal Dean.
Can we talk to him?
No.
Why not?
Principal Dean is a very busy man and doesn't have time to concern himself with students who will not follow orders. If you wish to speak with him, you can fill out a form that must be pre-approved by the board.
Where's the form?
Fill this out in triplicate.
Never mind.
Remember, stay in your section.
This isn't it. Half of this stuff isn't even helpful.
Well?
Where are you going?
Where does it look like I'm going? To another section.
But the administrator told us not to.
The administrator isn't here, right? And I mean, I think we should change our topic.
We can't.
Says who?
Okay, look. I know you're not really about this, but I really, really want to raise my rank.
Oh my god, the ranks aren't real.
What?
I don't think the numbers are real. And I don't think this school is either. Okay, listen. Did you hear about this school before you were invited to attend?
No?
Okay, well, exactly. You'd think that a school of this caliber would have some sort of promotion, right? They take the most academically inclined students and then they have them compete for class ranking. Don't get me started on the numbers. I mean, they give us numbers like we're test subjects. I think the government's doing this. They heard us.
Who?
They.
There you are. I thought I explicitly told you to stay in sections 22A through 23C. Anyways, RS2, Principal Dean would like to speak with you.
Wow, a drink designed to stimulate your synapses, specifically for bases.
Grog, it's actually pretty good.
I can't believe I got demoted again. 37 goes up 5 points for working on her project, but when I do, I get demoted to 24.
I heard that 15 fell asleep in physics last week and went up like 30 points or something like that.
I don't understand it. I do my homework, I study for tests. I mean, 15 hasn't done a single thing since she's gotten here and she's higher than me.
Well, maybe you're trying too hard.
You haven't done any work on our project and you're higher than me. How's your project, 13?
It's fine. River still hasn't come back
yet. You mean number 2?
Yeah, whatever.
That kid gives me the creeps. You know, if I were you, I'd probably work better now that she's not here.
They're always talking about like their conspiracy theories and stuff. Remember when they tried to get into a fight with 7 about how they thought that birds were government drones?
I mean, doesn't it bother you guys that she's been missing for like a week?
Not really. I mean, there's not a lot of places to hide in a boarding school.
She's probably getting fixed.
Mm-hmm. Wait, what?
You haven't heard? The administrator keeps bringing people into the dean's office. It's usually those kids who bend the rules. 36 and 18 got called in the other day because they were complaining about the grog. They came back though, just different.
So you think she's still in the dean's office?
Probably. But I'm sure River's fine. Principal Dean is super nice. And he knows my dad, so.
You met him?
Well, no. But my dad has, like, talked about him a bunch, so...
Well, I'm just worried because River brought up this theory that this school's one giant experiment.
Oh, please don't tell me you actually believe that.
Well, I can see how it could be, and if you guys just listen to me,
I mean, they're probably just making them all up for attention anyway.
You really think that stimulating sewage water is more believable than River's theory?
For the millionth time, it's grog.
It's actually pretty good.
Yes?
I need to speak to Principal Dean.
If you would like to hear from Principal Dean, you can...
No, I need to speak to him now. It's important.
Principal Dean is a very busy man and doesn't have time.
Where is his office? I can't find my partner. I need to finish this project now.
It's me. Stay on the lookout for 13.
River? Principal Dean?
Oh, you finally made it. Congratulations. You've been promoted.
I don't get it. What is this? Where's Dean?
Dean? He's just a washed-up actor we used for the instructional videos.
I'm sorry, I'm not following.
Okay, so you see, the point of the experiment was to highlight burnout in gifted children. And you showed real promise. I mean, within 12 hours, you found a way to combat the system. At least that's what I reported.
So you've been working for them?
Recruiting. We're looking for non-conformists, people who think outside of the box. In a school full of geniuses, it is impossible to find someone that thinks for themselves.
Why me? I didn't even care about the school, I just wanted the scholarship.
It's very hard to find someone that, you know, doesn't conform to the system. It can take months, but you did it almost immediately. It showed real promise. You're getting an opportunity that few students will ever have. I hope you join us.
What if I don't?
Then you'll be gone by morning.
I don't think the numbers are real. I don't think the school is either.
I'm sure you're all very excited to receive your first assignment today.
All of you have been ranked according to your scores.
Oh my god, the ranks aren't real. And they give us numbers like we're test subjects.
After all, we are like cogs in a big machine, right?
I don't think the numbers are real. I don't think the school is either.
After all, we are like cogs in a big machine, right?
Big breath. It's showtime.
You got this, Melissa.
I know. I know.
Good morning, Lincoln High students. At this time, I'd like to bring out your two candidates for school president, Miss Melissa Bloomberg and Mr. Tony Smith.
I'm Melissa Bloomberg. And if I am elected as your next student council president, my number one priority—
Boring! Come on, Melissa. Let's talk about what really matters. Who's gonna make the students of Lincoln High happier? That would be me.
Yeah!
You'll see the difference.
Go, Tony! Yes!
I smell your rank lies, Melissa. Melissa.
How does anyone take this guy seriously?
Just who is? Stupid American.
Melissa!
Whoa. Hey, Tony, have a little bit of respect, please.
We all know that this school has been missing something. A homecoming. That is why I'm happy to announce that we've already reached 50% of our fundraising goal. What have you done for our school?
Done so much. I mean, it's like...
I'm currently captain of the tennis team, on the board of the current events club.
Sounds like a candidate who's only in it for the title class president.
Amen!
Pejorative comments like this are a distinct sign of immaturity.
Pejorative comments like that, Joanne, they're dying of immaturity.
Okay, I think that's enough. I think that ends the debate right here. Thank you, candidates.
There was a thick air of tension and expectation floating around our school as Tony Smith and my best friend, Melissa Bloomberg, squared off in a tense campaign for student council president.
Good morning, Lincoln High students. Your new class president is...
Melissa Bloomberg won the election.
We are so proud of you, Melissa.
You showed who's boss.
And you're also getting work done.
Tony's campaign was pandering. I mean, any other brand can see that. But you actually have some integrity.
Aw, thanks, guys. But I was just trying to do what was best for the school.
Sorry you didn't win, Tony. Everyone knows you should have been president.
Melissa Bloomberg is a 4 at best. How could anyone with a brain vote for her?
I overheard Melissa talking about some shady stuff at Mother UN. Have you considered
that she didn't really lose the election.
What do you mean?
Well, you know, she's tied to Prince Malone due to mom being on education board and all. You see how easy it would be for her to
rig the election.
But that's just the idea.
Wait, what's your name?
Speculation or not, that's exactly what Tony wanted to hear.
Melissa Bloomberg and Principal Malone have been spending long hours rigging that election. Expected that Melissa has had up to 8 abortions for her several teen pregnancies. Outside of the crack house, suspiciously injecting something into her left arm. Inside source, a Melissa Bloomberg has revealed that she showers only once a month. You know what I'm hearing? Melissa Smelissa.
All right, so we all know why we're here today, correct?
Because I'm telling the truth?
No, because you've been stirring up hate and making false and malicious claims about Melissa.
Thank you, Principal Malone.
Oh, come on, you guys are clearly in cahoots.
This school is founded on integrity, honesty, and respect. We don't rig elections here. She won fair and square. And you need to stop spreading lies or you're gonna suffer some serious consequences here.
Do you want me to call Daddy?
No. We don't need to be getting Chairman Smith involved, please. Could y'all please just stop?
Fine. I'll make a public announcement tomorrow. I'll revoke everything I've said.
Thank you, Tony. I'm sure this whole ordeal has been very stressful, you know? Especially for Melissa, considering she's, you know, a teenage mother.
You believe that?
Yesterday, I attended a meeting with Melissa Bloomberg and Principal Malone. I came to a realization. I could say this school is an unequivocally corrupt administration. In this meeting, Melissa Bloomberg and Principal Malone attempted to threaten me physically, emotionally, but Lincoln High students, I will not back down. We will take back our school by any means necessary.
What? What the f-
Hello?
Good day. You should know that Lincoln High is homecoming. In fact, never come.
Melissa, Smelissa. Melissa, Smelissa. Melissa, Smelissa. Tony won that election. Y'all rigged it.
You guys are idiots. Even if the election was rigged, do you really want someone who locks freshmen in lockers and rates women on scale of 1 to 10 to represent you as president?
Melissa, Smelissa, Melissa, Smelissa, Melissa, Smelissa, Melissa.
I won that election. I did what I was supposed to, but
that isn't good enough for this world.
What are you talking about? You won. That's the truth.
I guess so.
Hey, we still have the homecoming to look forward to. I heard you made the goal for the fundraiser.
Oh, school board hasn't agreed to it.
What? But you raised all that money, and your mom's on the school bus.
Melissa, you're not gonna believe this.
Tony just put up another poster.
You gotta come see it. Yeah.
I added up the numbers on her order history. It added up almost exactly to the money she raised on GoFundMe. Melissa used the money to pay for her own campaign. I couldn't believe it. Melissa was my best friend since—
What are you typing? I can't believe Melissa would be so dishonest, but I have to get the information out there. I thought you were my best friend, Alex. How could you do this to me?
You lied about the homecoming
class. So you want Tony Smith as your president?
No, that's not what I'm saying.
No, it is what you're saying. The only way I could have kept a monster like Tony from becoming president was if I had my own campaign. But campaigns are expensive. Can you imagine what Lincoln High would look like with Tony representing our school?
But Melissa, you lied.
That's politics, Alex. Lies. The best anyone can hope for is for the greater good. And I'm that greater good. Thank you, Rachel.
Alex.
Heard you and Melissa aren't so close anymore. How about I take you out of my father's boat sometime?
Why the hell would I go out with you? You've never accomplished anything in life. All you do is coast on your father's money and influence.
I've never done anything? I'm like a god around here. And you know what? I knew the election wasn't rigged. I lied and everyone believed me. And guess what? They won't believe you if you tell them. Because it's not the truth that matters. It's what I say.
Melissa stripped me of my voice, and Tony tried to defile me. But I still had faith in our students.
I am so glad you're all here today to witness the first student council meeting with me as your new president.
Sorry, little miss president. This toilet of a system is, and you all know it. I'm the real president.
I've had enough of you. You trust fund baby. This podium is for the president.
Everybody stop. What the hell is going on here?
Who's the president now?
Everyone stop fighting. I have something to say. I have the truth. And here's all the evidence. Tony lied to you about the election. It wasn't rigged and he knew it.
I knew the election wasn't rigged. I lied and everyone believed me.
And that homecoming we were all looking forward to, it was just a way for Melissa to fund her campaign. She even threatened me when I was about to publish the article. Both candidates are vindictive, corrupt, and plain mean individuals.
Who cares? Tony should still be president.
No, Melissa is the president.
Police arrived on the scene and broke up the riot between Tony and Melissa. Principal Malone suffered a broken nose. No one was president in the end. No one cared about the truth.
Доброе утро, Калина. Можем поехать за президентом? Спасибо. Работа задлана.
Are you seriously going to turn this down? It's easy, you just waltz in there, you get the money, and leave. We never have to talk about it again.
Yeah, I have some moral issues with this.
Why? You don't have to hurt her or anything. I just need you to make it look like she's bad at her job. We used to work here together before I quit.
Listen, this just seems more like a personal issue, you know?
You said you needed money for your next film? You go in there and do this, we can split it, 50-50.
Welcome to Breadwinners. How can I help you?
Hey, so we don't want to freak you out, but we were hired to rob you.
Don't worry, we're not actually going to do it, but the person who hired us does expect us to bring something back.
Wait, sorry, who are you?
We're just some guys off of Craigslist.
We're actually trying to raise money for this new
this
film.
This new film, it's gonna be
it's
so
about
good.
These two detectives.
Don't care. So you said the person who hired you was sitting out there?
Yeah.
Well, you can tell Abby that if she wants to rob me, she can rob me herself.
Wait, how?
I recognize the booger.
The booger?
The car. It's little. And green. Like a booger.
Doesn't look like a booger.
Get her in here. Where's my money?
You're gonna have to go in there.
What?
She wants to talk to you.
How'd she know I was here?
She saw the car. So it looks like a booger.
Okay, you know what? I'm not the one who needs to talk to her. She's the one who needs to talk to me because she's the reason I got fired in the first place. At least I have a car. She doesn't even have her license.
Hold on, I thought you said you quit.
Just go get my money!
Okay.
Okay. She thinks you're the reason she got fired.
And she basically said you're incompetent because you still refuse to get a driver's license even though you're 18.
First of all, I didn't refuse to get my license, I got it revoked. Second, she's calling me incompetent after she literally yelled at a blind person. How is he supposed to see the menu? She's
burned 20...
25...
Oh, sorry. 25 different pizza orders in one day, had the fire department deployed 4 times in 1 week, got labeled as a liability hazard within the first 30 work days.
I am not a liability! She's the liability!
I'm a liability? She's a freaking pyromaniac!
I accidentally started one grease fire on National Churro Day, and you didn't even try to help me put it out!
Yeah, because nobody puts water on grease fires!
Don't even start, okay? I took chemistry freshman year, I took chemistry sophomore year, I took chemistry junior year, senior year I took physics. Why? Because I passed chemistry!
Oh, don't you dare say that! You put ice cubes in a deep fryer because you thought it was too hot!
Listen, I know science, and science tells me to put water onto a fire to put it out.
Josh, what? She left the money on the counter.
Chris.
She's counting it earlier.
Are you thinking what I'm thinking?
I think I'm thinking what you're thinking.
For a film.
Yes.
How was I supposed to know the rest of the store was gonna go up in flames? I didn't. So excuse me for adhering to the laws of physics, but frankly, I have much bigger problems on my hands right now.
Oh, hello. I didn't see you there. I'm Huxley.
And I'm Brody.
Together, we are
the Slick Sleuths.
The newest
and bestest
detective agency in Savannah, Georgia. We've been best friends since
the womb.
We've got each other's backs, and now we've got yours. Call us at 912-346-5048.
Or visit our office at 2345 Tannell Street.
Hawks! Look at this! We got 5 views on the vid.
Brody, that's because you watched it 5 times.
Damn it.
Brody, there's something on the news.
Around 5 a.m. this morning, the Savannah Police Department recovered yet another body. This is the second homicide in the past 2 weeks. The Savannah Police Department believe both murders can be linked to the ongoing drug war between two rival gangs, the Ardsley Park Alphas and the River Street Raiders.
Now we just wait for the customers to roll on in.
Yeah.
Up these flyers that I had on YouTube.
Thought we would get more clients by now.
Yeah. Do you think we should close up shop?
What? No. You're just like the SPD. We need to stay on that grind because we're real detectives.
Are we?
I don't even know.
Hello?
Yes?
Hello? Are you all the Slick Sleuths?
Yes, yeah, that's us!
Oh, that's great. I'm Mrs. Willoughby. I saw y'all's YouTube ad. I desperately need your help.
Of course. What exactly, ma'am?
Well, you see, it's my son, Tim. Tim has always been the most wonderful son. But recently, there's been some changes.
He's been hanging out with some bad apples. I think he might even be doing
weed?
Oh no.
I would like for you to follow Tim and find out what he's getting and where he's getting it from. And I do not want the police involved. I don't want to get my Tim in trouble. Can you help me?
Of course, ma'am.
For sure, broski.
He likes to hang out at Chatham Square after school. That's where you can follow him from. Now, how much will this cost me?
A thousand money bags?
Two money bags. One now and one after the job's done.
Okay, that sounds good.
Oh, money bag.
And here is my business card, so you can contact me.
I think y'all just gonna be perfect to help me with this problem. Thank you so much.
Of course, ma'am.
Yeah.
So no problem.
Thank you.
Bam.
Okay. Yes. Thank you.
We did it.
Our first client.
Mr. Tim, let's go.
Come on.
This looks dangerous. I don't know if we should be here.
What are you talking about? That's what being a detective is all about. It's about the intrigue. Plus, think about the money bags.
I get so many free hits on that.
What was that? Did you bring somebody with you?
Brody, be careful.
What should we do?
Just follow my lead, okay? Okay, Brody?
Okay.
Tim, how's it going, my man?
Yeah, what's up?
I haven't seen you since your birthday.
Yeah, when's your birthday this year, man?
Do I know you guys?
Get him.
Dude, what the hell? Oh, dude!
Raiders, help!
That was a good job, Brody. Give me the gun.
Here you go.
What?
Let's get out of here. Let's...
Come on, Timothy. We're gonna take you back home.
I'm going.
Oh, my balls.
Tie up our little delinquent nice and tight.
What the hell? Where are you guys taking me?
To your mother, where you belong.
My mother's dead.
Don't you dare say that about Diana Willoughby.
That's so horrible.
Your mom is such a nice lady.
Brody, it is not burrito time.
Please, I'm so hungry.
Doesn't matter, we gotta keep our eyes on the road. We've got important cargo after all.
Who do you guys think you are?
We'll let your mother deal with you.
What's the address?
Here we go.
We got your boy, Mrs. Willoughby.
Mm-hmm.
We know you said just to follow him, but us slick suits go above and beyond. Your boy Timothy was in some real danger, weren't we, Timothy?
But don't worry, we got the situation under control.
Well, that's just wonderful. Please, come on in.
Mommy.
Home to mother.
Come on, Timothy. What do you have to say for yourself?
You idiot, that's not my mom. That's the kingpin of the Ardsley Alphas.
What?
No, Timothy, no. That is your mother, and she loves you very much. If she was the kingpin of the Ardsley Alphas, the single largest crime organization in the Chatham County area, trust me, I would be the first to know. Don't you see? Don't you understand? We're all gonna die here.
Timothy, enough of this. That's your mother, and we saved you from that gangster earlier, with the gun?
That gangster was my friend. He's a lieutenant for the River Street Raiders.
No. I've read about this. It's a Stockholm Syndrome.
Yes. Wow, that's not, yeah. It's just not
possible. I hate to break it to you, sweeties, but I am the kingpin of the Ardsley Alphas. Just look around you.
Holy cannoli!
And that boy that you've brought into my home is a head scout for the River Street Raiders, my rival gang. And all I wanted you to do was to follow him to find out where his hideout was and then tell me. That's it. But you all had to go and act like you're the next Sherlock Holmes and Watson trying to solve some big mystery. And now all you've done is got yourself into a whole lot of trouble. So, any last words, slick sleuths? Or should I say, sloppy sleuths?
Ma'am, may I please just eat my burrito?
Fine, have your last meal.
How's this for sloppy?
Got you now.
What the hell is going on?
Help! Help! Bodyguard!
I got you, ma'am.
Oh my god.
Nice shot, pal. Where's Tim? Oh.
You bastard!
Uh-oh.
Brody!
Time's up, buddy. Not my hucks.
Thank you, Brody.
I've always got your back.
Look behind you!
Meddling fools! You messed up the one simple job I gave you, you brought a rival gang member into my home, and you threw a baked bean burrito in my face!
Brody!
We're alive!
Brody, sacrificing a burrito at the end was genius. We are real detectives.
We are.
Timothy, we gotta get Timothy.
Timothy, are you okay?
Oh my god, my precious boy.
I'm calling 911.
I'm sorry you didn't get to eat that burrito, Brody.
Don't worry, Hux. I've always got a backup.
The amateur private detective agency, Slick Sleuths, recently took down the previously unknown Ardsley Alpha kingpin at her own home. The Slick Sleuths duo, Brody and Huxley, also took down the River Street Raiders through converting an inside gang member, Tim, who gave the police all the information they needed on the dirty underbelly of Savannah's crime scene. The whole city has these two to thank.
Hey, you got two more.
I can't, I have to go.
Tell Margo I said hi.
All right, for this next assignment, we will be working on character design. So you guys can either work with clay or you guys can make a figurine.
So, what are you planning? Your last project was really cool.
I think a sock puppet might be fun.
Okay, cool.
Brianna, thanks for seeing me.
Again.
Listen, Brianna, I know you're trying, but your art is just not unique.
Oh. You suck! Look at your art! It's so ugly! I mean, even I'm ugly.
Have you seen Brianna's recent drawing? I don't even know why she's in this class. How does she think she'll ever make it to an art college?
C. silly Brianna. You can't run away.
Brianna, thanks for seeing me.
Wait, so your puppet was making fun of you?
That makes it sound trivial. It was more tormenty.
Fine. So, what'd you do?
I woke up.
Nah, you gotta do more than that. Don't let the little puppet win.
What? What am I supposed to do?
Have you tried lucid dreaming?
I don't think that's something you can just do.
Yes, you can. I saw it somewhere.
Reliable.
Wait. See? It says here. You can.
I think we need to go.
I'm saving the site, though.
Fine.
You know you can't escape me. You know you want to join the chaos. So many choices out there. So many people to disappoint. Just join us. Boo!
So, the site says to separate being awake from dreaming.
That's easy.
No, like, frequently, like right now.
Like what? I'm not dreaming.
Yeah, like that.
This is stupid.
You're just grumpy.
Not dreaming.
Good.
Shut up.
Howdy, Brianna. Are you ready to join us? There are no colleges. No choices.
What do you mean by join you?
You could come with us to the place unbothered by possibility or pressure. An easeful trance. Or the puppet realm.
What?
This is a place you created when you were a kid. When the world was too stressful, you would escape here.
I don't like this. I want to go back.
Wait! You haven't even seen the best part yet. The puppet realm itself. But if you want to come back, you're here to stay at our party that never ends! Well, what do you say?
No.
No? What is there missing?
My friends, for one.
There you go! Family and friends!
Not my friends.
Your puppet mom would approve of art college.
No, that's not real. It's just felt.
Nuh-uh, not yet. What is there left?
You okay? No, I don't want this.
That's all right. You'll join us soon enough.
Hey, hon, wake up.
We need to open these letters, Brianna, before the deadline. I have to go to work soon, so I thought we'd do it now.
Okay. Accepted! Yes! Oh, your father would be so proud.
But what about RISD? I still have to choose.
What is there to choose from? Stability or starving?
Mom, you know that's not what I mean.
So you're already decided?
No, just give me until tomorrow, please.
Fine.
We'll see you at dinner.
Looks good.
Another to disappoint.
Brianna, you okay?
Yeah, sorry. Thank you.
You know, that's really good. Are you gonna keep this up in college? Brianna, are you all right?
Yeah, sorry.
I hope so. That's my plan.
Good.
I'm not dreaming. I don't want to! Yeah, I'm sorry. I didn't sleep very good.
Maybe you should go home.
No, not home. That's where he is.
Okay, well, I hope you feel better.
Hey, why don't we stay here for a while?
Why? It's Friday. I want to go home.
No, not home. Not dreaming.
Dreaming. Are you okay?
Yes, I'm fine. Why does everyone keep asking me that?
Whoa, calm it. I was just checking in on you.
I don't need help. God, just get in the car.
Fine, crazy.
What did you call me?
Nothing.
I'm sorry, I'm tense. The dreams are getting worse.
Okay, well, maybe you need to confront it.
Maybe. A dream.
So, you are going to join us?
No, but I want to know more.
Well, in the puppet realm, you don't have to do anything.
Can you be more specific?
You could eat all the ice cream in the world, or study art.
Okay.
Wake up.
There's no one to disappoint. We choose when to eat, where to sleep, where to go. If you want, you won't have to make a single choice.
No, I don't want to.
Fine.
Let me out! Let me out!
Brianna, wake up!
You can't escape me.
Brianna, wake up!
I could make your night hell.
Brianna, wake
up! Your father would be so disappointed in you.
Brianna, wake up! Brianna, what have you done?
Dear Mr. Vernon, we accept the fact that we had to sacrifice a whole lunch period in order to survive the zombie apocalypse, but we think you're crazy to make us write an essay telling you who we think we are. In the simplest terms, each one of us is a brain, an athlete, a princess, a lesbian, and a zombie? Wait, what movie am I even watching right now?
We get the barbershop club on board, the rest of the band kids will follow, and this student council position is on lock for us.
Yeah, like mob mentality. Yeah, I dig it.
Especially if we offer them a new PA system. I guarantee they'll eat that up.
Actually, I just ran the numbers, and even if you do get the band kids, you're still gonna lose.
Hey babe, I got an idea.
Yeah?
I could just beat up the other candidates.
Classy, but words are humankind's best weapon, the artillery of the human heart.
Oh, here we go.
The more that I immerse myself in high-level literature, the more that I realize the pen is mightier than the sword. Emily Dickinson, 1891.
Dickinson.
What?
What is that?
Mashed potatoes, I think.
You think that's food?
I mean, you kind of get used to it, even if it tastes like rotting flesh every day.
We're gonna have to find another group to vote for you. What about her?
The lesbian?
That's Georgia. We used to be friends back in the day, but like, I don't think she'll bite.
Yeah, like it's a lone wolf type thing. I dig it.
You all right?
I'm fine.
Say it, don't spray it.
I'm no genius, but something's not right with her. Well, at least the coughing stopped.
Next.
Holy Moses, I'm gonna myself.
Seriously, guys, what just happened?
Lila turned into a zombie. That's what happened.
No, no, zombies aren't real. That couldn't have been a zombie.
I'm afraid you're wrong.
What?
It all started with the school lunch. Poor health codes and the overcrowding of our school's new cafeteria created the perfect breeding grounds for Ophiocordyceps unilateris, a type of fungus that affects insects, takes over their bodies, killing their consciousness, and forces them to do its bidding.
We are here. We need to be here.
What about the zombies?
Yeah. What about the zombies?
So you really have been preparing.
I'm ready for anything. Don't touch that. That's for the vampires.
Leo and Eagle will disguise themselves as zombies, leading the horde away from the exits.
How are you gonna make us look like zombies?
Have you been trained in theatrical makeup?
We need more weapons to fight off the horde. Alexis and I will raid the gym supply closet, see if we can find anything.
Alexis doesn't go anywhere without me.
Fine. But I swear to God if you mess us up.
We'll be fine. We just need to work as a team.
Let's get these Zuckers.
All right, come on. This is never gonna work.
You gotta like whisper to them, you know? Become one with the zombie. You're a good girl, come on, right here. Come on. Not now, I've almost got her. Hey, come on.
Hey, over here, I found some more humans we can buy.
What are you doing? Walk, quickly. Now!
All right, Max, stay here and keep an eye out. Alexis and I will try to find these weapons as soon as possible.
You gonna be okay, babe?
I'll be fine.
You see anything?
No, not really. It's been a while since we last talked.
Middle school, I think.
When we were kids, you'd come over and we'd play princesses and watch horror movies.
You used to put your head on my shoulder every time you got scared.
I forgot about that.
I used to come over every day and to your mom. So, how long have you been with Max?
Only a couple months.
Listen, I know I just met the guy, but I think that... What are we gonna do? Kill it. You saved me.
Yeah. Yes.
Thank you for that.
No problem.
Max!
Did you get him?
Where were you?
Well, you see, I was over there, and then I saw a zombie, so I went over there. And then the zombie, like, went into the closet.
And you didn't do anything to stop it?
Oh, come on, babe. You know it's not like that.
Well, thank God Georgia was there to fight off the zombie. Obviously, you couldn't handle it.
Come on, you really trust her? I bet she planned all of this.
You really think I started the zombie apocalypse just to get with your girlfriend?
You know, maybe. My dad says never trust a lesbian.
What do we do?
Leave him for the zombies.
There's way too many of them.
Yeah.
We're gonna have to lead him somewhere.
Yeah.
Which means we're gonna have to split up.
Yeah. Wait, no.
Listen, I believe in you more than I believe in anybody else. You're like, on my list of friends.
Thanks.
All right, so you see this elevator over here?
Yeah.
Once you take it up to the third floor,
okay.
Go to Mr. Meek's classroom, pull the fire alarm.
Third floor, Meek's room, fire alarm. Got it.
All right. Yeah.
Ah!
the flip. And my most dear actors, eat not but flesh and brain, but utter sweet breath and hear them say, I do not doubt it is a sweet comedy, but no more words. Go away! Go away! Once more upon the Greeks, dear friend, once more, or we'll close up our wall of English dead.
They should be here by now.
Guys, we did it. There's no more zombies in the school.
Leo!
Max?
You. I'm gonna kill you.
Yeah, I think we picked up on that.
You did this to me. You turned me into a monster.
I like to argue you did it to yourself, but...
Ray.
Is that really all they want? They're zombies.
You turned my girlfriend into a lesbian!
What do we do?
Kind is mightier than the sword.
So, what now?
Do you guys want to get food?